So before the run even starts, time starts before you hit game start when running this game.
Yeah, I'll tell you when to start the time. So basically, there's been a whole bunch of there's been a couple of, like, crazy discoveries as far as BK percent. There's a bunch of like cool. There's one in particular really fucking hard to roll. They're in Russian gear right now.
Which Tesla has gotten it once.
Now
slightly infamous reaction video of him getting it.
So I'm not gonna do that. So I was thinking, like, I kind of came up with a way to try and sort of, like, hybridize some, like, one of the new tricks, main menu moves, with some of the old routes. It requires, like, a big series of moon jumps that I just, like, haven't been getting for the last couple of days. Basically, if you, it's the last couple, you have to make, like, six moon jumps consecutively, and the last two, if you fuck them up, you basically have to start the whole thing over again, which doesn't only include the jumps, but it includes, like, a set of which that are the same.
Yeah.
But so it's like a 5 minute loss every time you screw it up, and there's no backup plan. You cannot, like, if you, once you commit to this route, you have to screw it. So I think I'm just gonna take the same route that I can easily do in this hour, instead of digging around on it, which then I'll be doing for the whole game.
Okay. So really wanna see some like walk.
Oh yeah, I'll show that out. So basically, I'm gonna try and start the time, like, as soon as I push A to start intro story, but I might fuck it up. James, you know.
That's part of the timer, though.
It's when the time doesn't come on.
Yeah, when the song doesn't come on.
Well, for marathon timing, the timer starts when you start playing. So if you have to reset, it's part of the timer.
Okay, fine. 3, 2, 1, go.
Anybody who's played this game before but not seen a speedrun of it is
in for a treat.
Going to be mildly surprised at the worst. At no point are you actually playing Donkey Kong 64 the way any sensible person is meant to be playing this game.
So as you can see, the first thing that happens was we watched the intro story once or twice and then quit playing. There's actually some crazy pointer arithmetic going on under the hood that is teaching the Kong family things they are not meant to know. This is basically less of a speedrun and more like someone showing up to your house with a large weapon, Dark Souls style, and saying, "Perform it for you."
So, if anybody who's played this game legitimately before, I see, know that the Diddy Kong is not supposed to be played on the title screen. That is because the intro is kind of sort of playing at the same time as the menu and starting the previous file and other
and multiplayer.
What's even funnier is that this is not even as broken as this game gets.
Yeah, I wish I could show off some of the really crazy stuff. Maybe if we have, for some reason, finish really out of this game, we'll show off other things.
This is easily the most broken game on 64. Or it's the second most broken behind Ocarina of Time. depending on what you define as broken.
Say this game is more broken.
You can't arbitrarily write anything into your inventory, which you almost can. But unlike Ocarina of Time, you can just walk through walls.
I was watching that. So, when do we explain the unifying theory of lag?
I think I'll just kind of wait for the game progresses.
Okay.
Worst case, I guess I'll just deal with like a piece of torch or something.
So this is a training barrel that makes me have to throw barrels, learn how to throw barrels, but because of that.
Well done!
programmers were lazy and just copy and pasted the throw oranges trigger into every barrel.
Oh, you're gonna learn to swim too?
Yeah.
But you already did.
Yeah.
Oh, you gotta learn vines?
So
oh, right, that's an Aztec.
Yeah, so here's now where I have to learn how to throw vines.
Vine thrown.
Well done!
Alright, so we learned how to do a bunch of stuff. So now we're supposed to go back so you can teach us a move that lets us get out of this area. But that's kind of slow, so I don't really feel like doing that.
Let's go for swim instead.
Yeah, let's just go for swim. So this is a really cool wall, and I'm gonna look at it pretty closely.
Oh, sup, loading zone.
Oh, so now we've left the area.
That's cool. That's convenient.
I'm gonna go up and sleep. I've been up
all
night.
I feel bad for the five people who have left the stream. They're missing out.
Talks. So now we're gonna go to the fairies.
I might show up later, or I'll probably show up in the stream.
Hi.
So we have to go talk to the fairies. Tiny Conk is supposed to come here. You're supposed to like shrink in this barrel. But that just like takes a long time, so why even bother?
I am.
He runs in like.
What's really surprising is the coders in this game are really lazy, but they're surprisingly very unlazy here. You can get into here as basically yet. She doesn't just say tiny, she says Donkey Kong, or Chunky, or Lanky. They actually robustly coded that section of the game.
They put in percent case. S.
Yeah. percent Kong, just in case you're
percent Kong.
And that is probably the only well-coded section of this game.
The banana fairy wrote this game.
So this is K-Lunzi. He's locked in this cage. We need 8 keys to free him, maybe. So he's gonna tell us his plight, and I'm just not gonna listen to whatever. We need to collect a key from each of 8 levels to finish the game, at which point he'll set things in motion and we can beat up Hyrule. We might deviate from the final level.
What you're theoretically supposed to do is you need that first key from the first level, and you open up the second level. Opens up the third and fourth level. Then when you beat the fourth level, it opens up the fifth and so on until you've beaten all 8 levels.
So right now, he opens up level 1 for me, so let's go to level 1, and we'll go get key number 1 to unlock, to start the whole chain of unlocking this guy. So it'll be a lovely experience.
Wonderful, wonderful experience.
Wonderful
yes.
experience.
Yes.
For everyone. Keys are important.
Your run's in like 12 hours, by the way. You might want to get some sleep in between. Oh, okay, you're fine, I guess. I plan on
missed a little cut
going to sleep.
So here's level 1, and here's B-Locker, the most incompetent person in this game. It takes 1 gold for the turbo, which I happen to have. So, you know, that's fine. That's normal. That's usually how it's supposed to go. So welcome to Jungle James. I'm not gonna be here for very long.
We're in the air.
Yeah,
and that is not even the most eldritch of them all.
Yeah, actually, I think it's probably not the Shadow Chile. The game, so you can, if you like, attack off an edge and then pull it up again afterwards.
You can definitely do that in this game.
Yep. Here I'm just passing the cutscene, the shorter cutscene.
The cutscene normally pans across this entire area, then Diddy talks to you, then it slowly pans back. It wastes a lot.
The Squawk tells you, like, welcome to Jungle Japes, go do this. But
he's actually teaching you how to use the rope.
Oh, okay.
Yeah,
which
that's,
we didn't
that's,
touch until now.
That's why, that's a shorter cutscene. So, we have to go and get this banana. So great, we're up to 2 out of 200 golden bananas, that's awesome.
200?
Yeah,
200.
This game actually has around 4,000 collectibles. So, we'll we'll do a tally at the end of the round. So we gotta go hit all these switches now to free Diddy.
That camera! Ugh! So nauseating.
That he has the gun, mysteriously. And the sniper attachment.
Yeah.
Even more mysteriously.
Shipped it by ground mail.
So yeah, all that finagling with the menu at the beginning of the game, and the playing the cutscene and then leaving, you know, using Rambi and then doing multiplayer by yourself. That basically tricked the game into giving John all of the upgrades that he needs, basically.
Not the stuff you would have in multiplayer.
Yes. Which is the ground pound, the sniper scope, and the guns for every gun. And the second melee?
Yeah.
No, not second melee.
You said here?
Yeah, so we've saved the bomb. Now we're going to be level 1.
No, actually, that's not.
I don't feel like being level 1, so that's fine. We don't actually have a key for level 1 to open level 2, but that's okay.
Normally, to be able to fight the boss, you have to pick up bananas. There's 100 bananas for every comp, so there's 500 for every world, and you need a certain number of them in order to fight the boss. And you have to also sit through a pig feeding these bananas to a hippo thing. It's a long. And then you also have to fight the boss, and there's lots of cutscenes involved. And let's just go into outer space instead.
Outer space already. We sent a monkey into space once, we can do it again!
So,
into space!
You can kind of just fly.
Let's see why Buckfoot wouldn't be able to fly.
Yeah, sure. He's got banana powers or something, I guess. That makes sense. So, when I said we're gonna go to level 2, I actually lied. We're actually gonna go to level 6. It was a small detour.
But you need 65 golden bananas!
I'm sorry, Doctor, I've already ruined it, but you are the most incompetent person in this game.
Oh! Second! Well, 1.5 try!
You have to mash it to get the longest.
Crystal Caves!
So welcome to Crystal Caves!
Beware of Seath!
Oh my goodness, my Seath fight earlier today.
So I changed my mind and we couldn't actually go to Crystal Caves. I don't really feel like it.
Good, show me butterflies.
Yeah.
So the idea.
Let's go back to level 2. I think that's probably more. That's where we're supposed to be, right? So let's just go and do that. Like I said though, I never actually turned in P1.
This is why you get films, so you get the camera. So you can aim it at this wall to make sure you throw oranges at the wall and then gets damage boosted into the level.
So, unifying theory of life?
Yeah, so basically, it's not actually. We say hello and goodbye to our friend B-Locker.
Never seen again.
We basically do a damage clip through that wall. We'll come back to the leg thing, I guess. So welcome to level 2. There's a important thing here. We'll get something.
Another 50 golden bananas, 5 blueprints, and 500 regular.
Yeah. All that shit.
All that stuff.
You can skip this cutscene with a really difficult glitch though. Even a clip out of bounds. Unsurprisingly. Earlier in that hallway. Thank you.
rather humorously, not only can you just go through walls, but there's also multiple ways to go through walls in this game.
Yep.
It's not discriminatory.
Oh, the frames lost. So, Cranky says, oh hey, good thing you managed to beat my training barrels. So here's that move that you need to leave the training area. Oh, fantastic. I can already do this one. Bonus special. So let's buy this move that you can get at level 2. And I say, okay, great, I'm gonna need this for the last boss fight. Rocket Drill Boost. And he says, hey, Diddy, why don't you buy this move that you need to level 3? And I'm like, well, I'm only in level 2, so that seems a little weird. Here's some guy. Fun fact, if you like look up like the backstory of like the official canon of Lanky Kong, no one even like knows who Lanky Kong is. He's like not related to the rest of the Kongs and they don't know who he is. That's like that's just like actually canon. They like deny that he's part of their family. I think in the instructional book later, or like the player's guide or something, Lanky Kong calls him
an outlier with the Innsmouth look?
Something like that. He's from like the...
Yeah, he's got the Innsmouth look.
So, doing my practice runs, I found out that today's easy glitch that I can no longer do consistently is to see them.
But I just want to look at these stairs. They're
I really
nice
just
want to...
I want to look at these stairs really hard.
Don't you have to be parallel with the scene? Or?
No, it's not. You have to be a little off. Okay. But you want to actually walk off, right?
Right.
You can't just walk in unless you just stay on the edge. The idea of what's going on here is basically you fall, while you're just falling off this edge, you trigger zoom out like this.
There we go.
And instead of moving you outside, it, you fall straight down through the edge.
Yeah, according to Cranky.
Okay. When do we hit reset?
It's not here. That's one, that's one.
Oh, okay.
It's a tiny con.
Oh, okay.
So So I just really wanted to apologize to Walker is bad at everything.
It's a good thing he was never paid.
Yeah.
He doesn't even get paid in bananas. He just wants to see you have enough.
Running attack! Running attack! Oh my god!
I thought Trixie was from the show.
Yeah.
Yeah, sorry, I mixed up Trixie and Dixie. Oh my god, James, how do you do that?
Yo.
The Diddy CF clip here is like the hardest CF clip in the
world. You get it every time.
I get it
like
every time.
Like first try. Yeah.
Well, so right here,
I don't know what
spell Kung starting with G.
Yeah, so this is a good example of hard puzzles in DK64. We've got to spell a really mysterious word using the letters K-O-N-G.
And just in case you couldn't figure it out, they're also on the wall.
Yeah, they're literally written above the cage that we're going to so we're actually supposed to do something else here. You're supposed to, like, raise some platforms so you can headbutt these switches. So instead, we're just gonna climb up and put them backwards or something. Oh god.
It's so big.
Yeah, I don't know. The pyramids in this room are so big. So we saved Diney, hooray!
Okay!
I didn't want to hit it too early.
But that was a bad run, so reset.
Yeah, we're just gonna reset. I didn't actually. I don't feel like playing anymore until we start that run. So that's fine. This game auto-saves, so that's why we're actually doing
this. It doesn't auto-save too quickly, so that's why I hesitated a bit.
Yeah.
Gotta make sure it finishes saving.
I've never seen it, like, not save for Tiny Unlock. Board and left level 2. I don't really feel like finishing level 2, so that's okay. So now we're gonna go level 3.
Chad has either been sleepy or we got DC'd.
Oh,
so cool!
Oh, someone's been right.
DK is still just inside. You can't quite fly over, so you have to kind of use the terrain. But you can base it.
And basically go through anyway. In the same way that Ocarina of Time, there's some way to skip any given item in the game, there's some way to put through any wall in this game.
So I think you can just go through that because I don't think they were expecting you to climb up there.
Yeah, you're not supposed to be able to get up there. But, yeah, it sucks for them.
So here we are beginning to see the uniform in action. Which I'm kind of ready to explain.
Yeah, go for it.
Okay, so a revealing commentary from WarioWare's developers, they did like a little Let's Play commentary of Conker's Bad Fur Day, and they explained that they had a lot of programmers and they developed Conker's Bad Fur Day, Banjo-Tooie, and DK64 all at the same time. They're like, it's great we developed all that, but how do we do it? No, not through love, it was through hate. We all hated each other. We were all like competing. to try and make the best game. But the Donkey Kong 64 team was a bit ambitious and couldn't quite pull it off. Their game was getting really large, and they needed the expansion pack to get it to work, and they also noticed the game lagged a lot. So they went, this lag makes it pretty horrendous. How can we make it more playable? So they just said, oh, we'll just accelerate the Kongs while the game is lagging, so it feels like you're not lagging too badly, even when the frame rate drops. Now, oranges bounce around and have their own physics, and they also explode and have a big explosion with lots of frames to draw all this. So oranges cause a lot of lag. So, in theory, as lag increases, so too does Kong speed. So by using oranges to apply lag, you can accelerate the Kongs so fast that in one frame they can shoot all the way through a wall, and the next frame won't even be able to hit detect how far they move. So that's how a lot of these orange damage boost clips have been working here.
Yeah, you can kind of just accelerate beyond the speed of the boost.
Same with swimming through walls and see up.
Yeah, that's it's the exact same principle. When I just stare at the wall, when you zoom in on things, it like lags. Or sorry, when you go to first person, it lags.
So unfortunately, we only need Lanky basically to free Chunky. Because you can actually jump up this slope, but it's like, oh, you need Lanky to go up slopes because he walks on them, but Lanky doesn't even know how to do that. Unfortunately, it is a Lanky switch at the top, and not a generic blue switch. So, so many active frames.
Saving those frames.
We had to stomp on it anyway.
So the Chunky Kong is a lot of everybody's favorite Kong.
Wow, language, guys.
If you're playing with the
remix on
Smash Bros.
Oh no, is the Melee remix that
Yeah.
Okay. Yeah.
They say heck of a guy.
I didn't know that it played the whole song.
It does. Every Kong's verse is very stylistically different.
So we're gonna say hello to Candy Kong, and thank God this is gonna be the only time we have to see her.
Shout outs to the Sonic fandom. Now we have the fur bait for incentive to watch.
Creating generations of furries.
Lanky does in fact have to learn how to play music.
That stock fire sound effect.
Yeah, Lanky's a bit of a trombone.
Alright. Not as good as Chunky is.
He's not as good as Chunky.
That trombone too. Not just trying. I don't know how you got into that barrel, but I commend you, sir.
So now we're gonna go check on our senile level again. So he's like, oh, Chunky, you can buy this move. Level 1 extension. This is the move you get for level 3, you're on level 3, so that's fair. Then he says, hey, why don't you buy this super butt slam from level 5? Oh yeah, sure, I'll take it, why not? That seems useful. So the trick obviously was when I ducked into Crystal Caves, which is level 6, the game thinks that I'm in level 6, and it now offers me all the upgrades that you can get from level 6, which is pretty handy, obviously.
Definitely.
This is a fantastic game with fantastic upgrades. where they all just let you pull switches that are different colors.
I just feel so immersed in the role of these various monkeys.
Yeah, it's really
running around basically a giant training lab designed to torture humans.
That's basically what I'm asking for. So here's one of the boss rooms that we mentioned before. We need 200 bananas to get in there, and I don't have 200 bananas, so this could be...
But they do have some very nice stairs.
They've got some pretty nice giant stairs. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, I'm gonna take a close look at them.
Well, I'm an antique
expert.
Didn't
even see up there.
You can actually just do that without seeing. I'm kind of bad at see up glitches today, so I'm not gonna bother. You can skip this cutscene, which is kind of long, by exiting and then doing the see up clip to enter again, and then skip this cutscene, so it can save you like 10 seconds or 15 seconds or something.
But you gotta get it first try.
Yeah, you gotta get the see up clip for the first try. It's not happening for the design today, so.
Oh no, it's a boss.
Yeah, so we're in level 3 and we're gonna fight our first boss.
The rather infamous
Mad Jack.
This boss is actually kind of hard. I have 2 melons here. You get a second melon when you buy it for the last one, which I got. This is actually a pretty hard boss to do with only 1 melon. You can, basically, you gotta just run away from this guy. We'll bounce around a little bit. They throw some fireballs at you, and you can switch it to the torch.
Jack's so mad, Kremlins wanna find me!
Thank you.
still a problem in the new room where you actually fight this boss with Donkey Kong.
Yeah. Donkey Kong can also just see the boss.
Jack is just being a hero today. Yeah, he's not playing claw and adjusting with the C button.
Work out really nicely, then you can heal spawn like next to you even. So again with the whole loop.
Can you just unlock the game?
Donkey Kong, please. Alright.
While you're researching, I have a question.
Yep.
Why is that boss mandatory?
Okay, so we were saying, I guess it's a good time to explain the keys. What are you doing? We do have
hopefully
autosave.
Hopefully it autosaved after.
Okay.
As soon as you touch the key.
Yeah. So I'll still have the key. It'll cost me a few seconds until time to reset. We need key 3. So what normally happens in the game is key 2 unlocks level 3 and level 4 at the same time. Because the fan theory is, because Mad Jack is actually pretty hard. He's like the hardest thing in the game. They thought kids might not be able to beat Mad Jack, so they let you kind of skip the boss at level 3 and go on to level 4 if you want. And then the rest of the keys all go in sequence after that.
Camera freaks out when you clip into there. It can be hard to find the loading zone sometimes.
So yeah, normally you collect these blueprints and you give them to this guy.
And you just walk through the wall.
Oh yeah, that's just
it's just a thing.
So, V Locker's here. You gotta have, I think, 80 movements in here. And look at this. Because marathon is
blue banana's more of a suggestion.
Yeah.
I don't got time to switch to Lanky Kong and get out of here.
Yeah, you're supposed to use Lanky to get the steep slopes, but it's not actually good. Lanky actually sucks. Yeah. How would you go on a lovely adventure with Jungle
Cruise? A journey through time and space.
But apparently, King K. Rool's Mechanical Island is approaching DK Island and might do something to it.
Oh yeah, right. So yeah, King K. Rool's gonna fire a giant laser at Kong Island.
He's tired of us cheating to be back in the game, I guess. He's decided to take some initiative on his own.
So, fortunately, we can just easily complete this level without getting any of the controls I'm supposed to do. Chucky does not understand the rules.
The other Fundamentals physics in this game are strange, where basically it extends the floor of every room outwards and out of bounds. So, and it uses the floor of the room you're closest to, so you don't like fall into space, but you can sort of like ascend to higher rooms as well.
By default, you stay on the same like Z level as when you're out of bounds, but yeah, you can go back into the floor level of the nearest. So this is the one kind of everything part of this. There's a door up here where you're supposed to have, I don't know, some more of the collectibles. I think it's the coin. It's the real one.
I love what the camera does here.
You're actually there's no actual boss.
Oh, you exit?
Yeah, I just exit.
Oh, right. Yeah, the other route Nib was contemplating involves, disabling the start button.
I'll be talking about it a bit.
You're at 45
already. It's a little, this will be close if I can. Close to that stupid freeze.
Buddy, we kind of came up short on keys on busting you out. I'm not sure how you feel about that.
Woohoo! 1 in 8 keys, so we gave you keys and 1 in 8 keys.
No, no fit key. It's good. Sometimes when you pick up key H, the game doesn't know you picked up key H. It's called fit key. It's really fine. I have to redo level 8, or level 8.
It happened to Sea Fox.
Yeah, you have to just go do what I just did again. The whole thing.
They consider DK64 an awesome game.
No, I didn't get teleported one, did I? Oh, I did hit the other teleporter.
Oh yeah, you don't just want to like hit all 5 of those right away, because you have to save it for Jungle Japes.
So yeah, we gave him 2 keys that he actually needs, and he, he did some stuff in the cutscene that we skipped, and now we're fighting him.
I'm just like a big crater. His aircraft crash, and inside his aircraft is just a giant box.
With that.
Yeah, with a humongous Smash Bros. Brawl style confetti crowd.
Unfortunately, getting up to the top.
time we actually play.
That's right. Like,
oh my god, what?
Is the N64 just freaking out on me?
GG?
I think that might just be GG.
It's Ogre!
Oh no.
If you really want, I can reset and start the boss fight all over again.
Well, we mercy killed Super Metroid, because we're setting a trend.
Do you want my N64?
You might want to use the other N64 for your N64 runs. It might just be the cart, I don't know. Maybe it's dusty or something. But basically after this is just the chunky section where you get to punch K. Rool, and it's really satisfying.
Punch him in the face, and that's the end of the run.
I think that run was on pace to be like pretty much an hour on the nose. The tiny section's still another few minutes, but the chunky section's really short.
Nice.
But yep, I don't really feel like restarting that boss fight.
Yeah.
So
you should show off the swag walk.
Oh yeah, sure.
Swag walk.
That's really funny.
Doing that, I'll go get my stuff and use the washroom.
I'm just gonna sleep here during Banjo-Tooie.
I'll be back sometime.
Okay.
I'm actually going to be taking a snooze as well.
So we should probably close the timer.
Someday.
Yeah, James on.
What's the reset?
No idea. Something.